Next topic in your subject is requirement engineering. We are collecting all the requirements from the user. It is a initial stage of a software engineering. After collecting that, we are creating as a document. So requirement engineering is a process is to create and maintain system requirement documents. And what is this process actually? Requirement engineering is the process of identifying, analyzing documents and checking the services and constraints. Here we are following some steps to create the document. We are following some four steps here. One is flexibility study. Second one is requirement elucidation and analysis. Third one is requirement specification. Fourth one is requirement validation. In the flexibility study, this is nothing but assessing whether the system is useful for the business. We are collecting some information. We are collecting the user needs, but we are checking whether it is useful for the business or not. So by checking that, we are creating a flexibility report. Second one is your requirement elucidation and analysis. In this, we are discovering the required information. We are discovering the requirement of the users and systems. Here we are creating a graphical model. That model is nothing but a system model. Next step is a requirement specification. Here we are classifying user needs and system needs. That is your user requirement and system requirement. And here all the user needs are formatted or converted to standard form. So at last we are doing the validation. So in that we are checking whether which satisfies your user needs or satisfies your system need. That's all. As I told you already, four steps we have: flexibility study, concerns with assessing whether the system is useful to the business or not. Second stage is requirement elucidation and analysis. It collects all the requirements or it discovers all the requirements from the raw input. Next step is your requirement specification, which converts all this requirement into some standard form. Here we are doing the classification of user needs and system needs. Next we are doing the validation. It is a requirement validation and checks the requirements actually satisfies your system need or customer need. So now we'll see one by one, step by step. First is flexibility study. This study is used to determine if the user needs can be satisfied with the available technology and budget or not. Flexibility study checks the following: does the system contribute to organizational objective or not? Can the system can be implemented using current technology and within the budget or not? And now one more condition here is, can the system can be integrated with other systems or not? So can be able to adapt with the other environment or not? Likewise, we are checking some condition here. If the system does not support this objective, it has no value to the business. Flexibility study is based on the information assessment, information collection and report writing. So whenever you are collecting the information, carefully we need to collect the information. The information has to be useful for develop your project. Otherwise we can omit it. So we'll have a sample questions here. What if the system wasn't implemented? What will happen? Was our current process problems? How will the proposed system helps? What will be the integrator problems? Like that, some questions will be asked whenever you are collecting the information. So next step is a requirement elucidation and analysis. In that, we are discovering the requirements. From this, we are discovering the requirements. So here, whatever the requirement, they are collected from the stakeholders. The stakeholders may be a single person or group of peoples. They will be affected, who will be affected by the system directly or indirectly. Example, end users, managers, engineers, domain experts, etc. From the stakeholders, we are discovering the requirements. So in this phase, what are the drawbacks we are facing here is drawbacks of elucidating and understanding stakeholder requirement is stakeholders do not know what they really want. Stakeholders express requirements in their own terms. Likewise, different stakeholders may have conflicting requirements. Next, organizational and political factors may influence the system requirements. Likewise, we have some problems in selecting and understanding the stakeholder requirement. In the second step, that is steps involved in the requirement elucidation and analysis, we are following four steps to collect the requirement. First step is here. Requirement discovery. This is the process of interacting with stakeholders in the system to collect their information. Here, we are collecting the information from the stakeholders. Here, domain requirements also identified. So, next is, after collecting the requirements, we need to classify it. We need to group it. That's we are doing the second step. That is, your requirements classification and organization. And the next step is, your requirement periodization and negotiation. So, as I told you already, stakeholders will have a different opinion. Sometimes they will have a conflict in their opinion. So whenever you are having the conflict, we need to break it. How they are breaking is that by prioritizing the requirements. They are giving the priorities for the requirements. In this way, they are finding the requirements and they are solving the problems. The last one is requirement documentation. They are doing the proper documents for the requirements. So in this, they give the definition for user specification and system specification. Here they are doing two documents. One is formal documents, another one is informal documents. In the formal document, we have a formal information. In the informal document, we have an informal information. This is the spiral diagram for requirement elucidation and analysis. We are repeatedly doing the four steps in order to discover the requirements. So what are the four steps? Requirement in the requirement elucidation, follow the four steps.